Hello everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to talk about the struct structure as like as array is a gathering or of information as one type, but the difference between array and struct is that the elements in array has the same type. But in a structure, we can have elements of different types. An example, if we have struct cards, we are going to define struct cards clamp, and inside this clamper, you are going to have two different elements, one of them of type int, one of them of type char. In this the declaration, struct is a keyword, card is the structure tag name, and the variables pipes and suite of member of the structure. The variable pipes can take values between 1 to 13 and representing ace to king, and the variable suite we take values for C, D, H and S, standing for clubs, diamonds, hearts and spades. Then you can declare two variables C1, C2 by this definition or declaration, struct card, C8, C1 and C2. This declaration allocates storage for the identifiers C1 and C2, which are of type structure card. And they are the same, they have the same members and the same members and types. You can instead of this, you can directly, after that you declare a struct, you can after that put C1 and C2. Which is often the at the same time you declare two variables too. To access the member of a structure, we use the member access operator. Let us assign to C1 the values representing the tree of a spade. Then the pipe, we are going to use C1 pipes. That variable has number 3, and that variable in C1 take the character S as a spade. Programmers commonly use the type definition mechanism when using structure types, and another we are going through later. An example is that you are going to use type def struct card and again card. Then in the end, you are going to use that card as a macro, locale macro in program C3, C4, C5, and you declare three more identifier. You can even declare an array as a struct card. Struct card, in pipe, char suite, and the end, deck 52, which has the same, it is an array of elements who has all of them the same type structure card, the same type, each element. Each element has the same type, which is struct card. If a tag name is not supplied, then the structure type cannot be used in later declaration. An example is, you can use struct without any name and int day month year and character day name for month name for two arrays of character, and after that you can use three identifier, yesterday, today, tomorrow, as be the struct, but it hasn't any name. This is not good. This is not good, and it doesn't work properly. But when we use struct date, int, day, month, year, char, day name of four, month of month name of four, and then we can use the struct date, yesterday, today, tomorrow, three identifier as struct date. The date is a struct structure tag name, and we can declare a variable of this type. When using type definition to name a structure type, the tag name may be unimportant. For example, we have a type definition struct float3 imp, and the end we are going to name it complex. Then we can use the complex as a local macro variable and declare A, B, and C as an array, as a complex which is a struct. And a structure can consist of function too. Struct type definition struct point, int p1 double x double y, which is an array, and int I, it is a function with three different parameter, and another function copy of type double with two different parameters, one of them array of integer and one of them integer double variable, another function of type float with two parameters, array of double and array of integers, and at last we can use the same name or you can use another name in the end. And then that point is going to be the macro, a local macro identifier in your program, because you have used type definition. In order to get a proper and clean program, you can make a header file containing structures and functions. We are going through in the later use later, but I am naming here because your program maybe contains functions, few structures, few enumerus, a few union, and when you are going to put in your main program, it's going to be very heavy. But to make it more proper, to make your computer, your program runs quicker, you are going to make an header file, a local header file. You can make it. In that header file, you call it example dot h. You are going to use your include header files, and you are going to use define constants or variables, and you are going to use your structure, and you are going to use your functions, and with their definitions in that header file. And in your main program, instead of at include all those header files, you are going to use only include example dot h. And in your main program, in your main function, you are going to only use you are going to call only your structure, which is here. And this structure contains three different functions, which you have defined them, declared and defined them in your local header file. Structure can also contains other structures. For example, type definition, employee struct, employee. You have variables char, an array of char name with 25 elements, int, an integer ID, structure department, structure address, and a usual variable, the double variable salary. You can use employee or another name, but it is type definition, and that employee is going to be used as local macro, and you can declare another structure, another identifier with the same structure, and you are going to, you must define structure depth, and you must define the structure address, that this one is going to be valid. I am going through a simple program, and I have used include studio.h and include studylib.h, and I have defined an identifier class size 100 item, 100 value, and it is a variable integer with value 100, and I have declared an structure student type definition, and I have called it a student again. And that structure has three elements. One, a pointer, char of pointer, last name. You can use an array, but I have used pointer. If I use array with 100, it's going to allocate huge place in the program. But But when you use pointer, it's going to use exactly the length of that last name only. And the last names has a different length, and it's going to be to allocate shorter places in memory. And it has the integer ID and a character grade, and I have declared a function, a pointer, a function of pointer integer with type integer, and this function has a parameter struct student, and we have called it class, which is an array. In our main, we must name, we must use that type definition, that student, which is a local macro variable, and I have declared two structure, temp or class, which is a array of the length class size 100, and I have declared a pointer p, and I have defined the elements. I have initialized the elements in the structure temp, the grade. When you want use the, you want initialize or you want use one of those members, you are going to use dot temp, the name of a structure, dot grade, means that the variable grade in structure temp I have initialized with A, the last name of the temp, or the variable last name in structure temp, temp dot last name is Casanova, and the ID in the structure temp is 910017. And in class, in temperature class, without initializing the last name and ID, I have used the grades. The class, the first element in class, in a structure class, its grade is A. The second element of structure class, its grade is B, and so on. And I have also used a for loop to put the different grades in for different a member of structure, array of structure class. And I have used, because the function fail is a pointer, then I have used an integer, and it returns integer, and it has a type integer. I have declared an integer, a pointer of integer p, and I use only p equal fail of structure class, and I don't need use class with the clam parentheses, only class. And what is happening in the function? I have declare two integers, one I and one pointer of integer c and t, which is count. And I have, because I don't know how big is going to be, I have also allocate memory with something. I have used, because c and t is an integer, I have used implicit conversion of malloc, which is allocating of memory, and it is in the stdlib header file. And I have used malloc 5, which has 5 indicates 5 A, B, C, D, F. It is 5 different degrees multiplied by size of int, which is 4 byte, and it is 4. Then it is going to allocate 20 spaces in the memory for our variable count. And I have used 4, I equals 0, I less than size of z, which is the size of class, the array class. And I have used c and t 0 increments with class the member class, the grade of the structure class, if it is A, and it's going to be 1 if it is, if that condition is correct, it's going to get a value 1, and I am going to increment the count with 1. For grade B, grade C, grade D, grade F, I have used the same. Why? I have used C and T of the first element, the second element, the third element, fourth element, and fifth element. And it is 5. And each of them has the size of int, which is 4 bytes. And as you know, you cannot define c and t as integer and return c and t. You cannot return an array. But when you declare c and t as pointer and your function as pointer, then you can return. You can use the pointer as array, because an array is a pointer. You can define a pointer as array or initialize as array, and then you can only return that variable without pointer, because it has pointer, and it has pointer, you only use return c and t, which is the pointer, and it is accepted. After that, you can use another for loop and you can print the result and see how many has A, how many has B, how many has C, how many has D, and how many are failed. And we are going to compile. This is okay, and we are going to run. Yes, we have six persons has between six and 11 is 4, and 5, and 1 has 8 here before, and it is 6. To be is 9, and 1 here is 10. To C is 1 here and is 10 and is it was 10 here and it is 20 here and it is 31. And then for grade D we have 30 here, and for grade F you have 20 and 3 before, and it is 23. Okay, it was all in this tutorial, and I hope that it can help to declare a student, and always use type definition, and in the end of structure you can use the same name as a structure tag name, and so that it's going to be local macro variable, and you can use it that one to declare another variables as a structure, and you can use you can initialize the member of structure, and you can use a function of pointer of function which elements is a structure, and you can return an pointer in the function of pointer. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.